So here for this episode of that with Sarah Booker-Lewis, local democracy reporter. I'm heading towards a festive period, Sarah, and we're going to start off with talking about the tech committee and domestic abuse strategy funding again. I was talking to Councillor Steph Powell about that from the Green Party last week. You've got an update as well.
Yes, indeed. Now, this is very much in Steph Powell's domain. So the council received 600,000 from the government from the newly renamed Department of Levelling Up Housing and Communities, which is now headed by Michael Gove. This used to be Robert Jenrick's domain. So, yes, and this is all to do with the Domestic Abuse Act created this year. And it's to make sure that people who are experiencing domestic abuse and their children have the support that they need. So there is a Sussex partnership, East and West Sussex and Brighton and Hove. They work together and they're carrying out a needs assessment as a group at the moment. But in September, the councillors here at Brighton and Hove, they agreed spending on 420,000, and that included 90,000 for RISE for their support work for the LGBT community. And this time, the councillors are being asked to approve spending on the remaining 170,000. And that's going to go on four services. The largest portion is a sanctuary scheme, and that's providing security for people who want to stay in their own home rather than go to a refuge. A refuge is very much the last resort for people that really are often fleeing for their own safety. Whereas if you can stay in your home, it is much better for everybody's mental health and well-being. So the second largest amount, that's for floating support for people who are in safe accommodation. Doesn't matter how long they've been there, they're going to have this bundle of money. Now, the rest of it, there's a flexible fund. That's to help with money for things like deposits, white goods, your fridges, your washing machines, and moving costs. Because very often survivors who go into a refuge situation, they're leaving with nothing but the clothes to stand up in and nothing else. So that will help them. And finally, they're putting £10,000 towards interpreting. That includes British Sign Language, because that's not something that they have enough funding for at the moment. Now, what was quite interesting was to find out from the papers going to tech this week is that Brighton and Hove doesn't actually have a sanctuary scheme or a floating support scheme. This will be very useful money to support men and women who are experiencing these issues.
Yes, so that's quite an important development. And there is a spike in domestic abuse cases over the festive period, don't forget as well, isn't there? But it's, well, after the New Year's, the highest time for divorce rates as well, isn't it? So it is kind of a difficult period for some people, isn't it?
It can be a very tough time. There's a lot of worry, actually, around lockdown with increased domestic abuse, and in a similar way to Christmas, when you've got people who are in close proximity to each other for long periods of time, it can put strains on some relationships. And then with Christmas, you've got the added issue of maybe people spending too much, drinking too much, hanging around with members of the family they don't like very much, and it can build up into additional problems. I think alcohol is probably a great that creates a lot of problems with domestic abuse. And yes, I know people myself who have spent the New Year in hospital after a very poor Christmas. Christmas Day, fine. Boxing Day, not so much.
Yeah.